Hello and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Steve Minich. Is MaineCare's non-emergency transportation improving, or have its riders given up on calling? That's what the Health and Human Services Committee was trying to figure out Tuesday in Augusta. MaineCare and DHHS have received thousands of complaints about the shuttle system, which switched brokers back in August. MaineCare and its providers say the system has improved, but representatives are worried that too many people have already given up on the rides. Bond question number one on Tuesday's ballot approves borrowing $14 million to fix Maine's armories. The Maine National Guard wants voters to know what they are voting on when they go to the polls next week. The Guard has launched a public awareness campaign and was more than willing to show us some of the issues the aging buildings have. Only seven lawmakers opposed this bond, several of them telling us their votes were simply votes against borrowing money. But the head of the Maine National Guard says this is money worth spending.
I don't think I'm going out on a limb by saying that we have soldiers and airmen who are deployed in Afghanistan and elsewhere right now whose facilities in theater are in better condition and are safer than the ones that we're asking them to work in here back in Maine.
I just think as politicians, we took an easy way out. We did the things that we wanted to do in the budget. And then we said, well, we can always bond the important stuff because people always support bonds.
Approving this bond would also trigger matching federal funds. The general says these awful conditions do not mean the Guard is any less prepared to deal with statewide emergency. And thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Steve Minich. Make sure to check back on WMTW.com and our mobile app for the top stories and weather anytime.